Hi, I'm Kevin Frobus. As a member of the IFRS advisory team in Sydney, I can attest to the fact that we are well and truly into the implementation of the new accounting standards. This month, I'd like to talk to you about one of those standards, the revenue standard, IFRS 15. In April 2018, in our accounting news, we introduced the five-step model that's embedded in IFRS 15. Since then, we've presented articles dealing with the first two steps, identifying contracts with customers and identifying performance obligations. This month, we look just at step two, identifying performance obligations, and specifically at the complexities and the judgments that are involved in determining performance obligations. This is an area that many clients struggle with, partly because of the aggregation criteria in the standard, that is, determining at what level to group goods or services that transfer to customers. Clients also struggle with the concept of activities that are necessary to perform performance obligations and the actual transfer of goods or services that are performance obligations. We have five very detailed examples in our article this month. The first is the offering of free goods, and we take a simple example, a gym bag offered with a gym membership. We then expand that and demonstrate the complexities and the judgments that can arrive. For example, one of the examples looks at offering of discount vouchers for your next purchase, and then also we look at things like sign-on fees for gym memberships and complimentary vouchers. We've also had a look at the design and the building of a house and how the aggregation would work, and finally, we've put software into the mix. I probably receive about one quarter of my queries related to the revenue around software. So the example in this month's article looks at software customization.